As we discussed in the class, the right thing to do here was to use the factory pattern. So here is a possible code that solves the problem. Of course, there are different possible solutions. So what we did for this code was to first create a private static singleton object called instance, which is the one that will keep track of the only instance that can be created of the class. Then we define the default constructor, the constructor that doesn't take any parameter, as private. In this way, other classes cannot create instances of singleton without calling our factory method. And finally, we create the factory method. And the factory method is fairly simple. The method will first check whether an instance of the class was already created. If it was created, it will just return that instance. Otherwise, it will create a new instance and assign it to the instance member variable and then return the newly created instance. So with this code, you're guaranteed that other classes cannot bypass the factory method because the default constructor is private and that the factory method will create one and only one instance of the class, which is exactly what our requirements were.